Nanti proses water absorption pada ekspansionnya semakin meningkatkan ekspektasi rentang ini and we can bersama financial advisor and also our human resource expert Tejibunyo. I will be the business analyst for this day. As a business analyst, I study the external analysis and also the internal analysis of this day, and I advise my department members so that they will do a better implementation but understanding the external and internal environment of this day. Now I will tell you a brief introduction of HPE Inc. HPE was founded in 1939 by Dave and his colleague Helen Gargill. But the name HPE was created when Helen and Packard Bushnell was drawn from their names, who were the founder of HPE. And in 2015, because of the economic retrenchment, the current CEO, who was Meg Whitman, decided to split the company into two, where HPE Enterprise were in charge of retaining servers, data storage, software, networking, and associated services, whereas HPE Inc. will sell PCs and printers. Now I will explain to you the problem statement of the one who created by business analysts. Basically, my main problem statement highlighted three main problems that was created by HPE. Basically, the HPE revenue fell to 6.3% in 2016. As you can see, there is a comparison data between 2015, the first quarter, and the second, the 2016, the latest quarter. You can see the revenue has fell from 3.9% from 2015 to 12.2% to 2016. And the second problem is the after sales services of HPE was less satisfying. You just type the after sales services in Google document, you can see a lot of complaints were made regarding the sales services. And lastly, the continuous innovation by competitors. These are the main competitors of HP, Dell, Lenovo, and Toshiba. And in these years, they have come up with new innovation. And because of continuous innovation by competitors, HP cannot compete. And because of that, their sales and other products have been degrading. General objective. Basically, we want to increase the sales, and to increase sales, we want to focus on improving our financial status. Second is we want to make sure our employees are trained well to cater the global consumers and their changing preference, and to maintain a very good preference among the customers. And lastly, our objective is to introduce new product in an existing market to boost the number of sales. Now, I will explain to you about the analysis of HPE SWOT. The strength of HPE is it's a pioneer in terms of brand recognition. As I mentioned before, it was founded in 1939, so many customers know the name just because of the brand. And another strength is, even though the number of sales is increasing, but the market share is keep on increasing, which is also a very good reference as the market shareholders will be very satisfied. And lastly, the strength is they are low in debt. As they are low in debt, they can actually put their money on some other investment to get a better product. And their weakness is their poor acquisition decisions to put in the declining sales. These recent years, HPE have been buying new companies, other companies to boost their sales, but it's not that good for their company as it's not good as they expected, it's not beneficial for them. And the business also lack in customer services, less innovation compared to its competitors. And the opportunity is they can expand the range of product, as I mentioned before, they can introduce a new product. And they should concentrate on a particular industry to boost the sales. And lastly, they should introduce customer loyalty of building programs. The trend is the latest technology used for continuous innovation by competitors, high cases of hacking and privacy violation, inflation lead to customers control their expenditure. So when HPE introduce a new product, they should make sure the price is reasonable for the customer. pathways. So it changes according to the pathway. And it is also obeying the government rules aligned with the HPSPC, which means the CSR projects and all other projects are according to the political rules set by the country. And it also enjoys greater political support in developing countries, for example, USA. And economic wise, first quarter of 2017 and earnings per share increased and rapidly increased in 2017. And social cultural wise, preference of consumer changing and the expectance on product increasing. And PC being replaced by smartphones and other technologies. Size of printers have been customer conveniency. And technology wise, HP should embrace latest technology, for example 3D printer, and they should use cloud computing to solve all their disputes. And they also should have future for technology is promising as the rate of population using IT related tools are increasing.
So hello, I'm the HP Operation Department, which is the production manager of HP. So now we're going through the problem statement. HP sales as mentioned by my business analyst has been increasing from 2015 to 2016 by 6.3%. And the overall computer industry also has declining from year to year. The current product does not meet the customer satisfaction in terms of the specification and technology advancement. Therefore, HP as an existing company should focus more on increasing their technological skills in order to venture into new sectors such as hotels and hospitals. The objective of the production department is to increase investment on the 3D printer by 8% in 2 years to be able to gain more sales. Venture into new sectors such as medical sector to increase sales. Improvise on current product, which is mobile phone and tablets, to meet the current technology innovations. This is the SWOT analysis of HP operations. First is the strengths, production excellence. Do you know actually HP is setting up for every second 2 computers and 2 printers. Therefore, it shows the dominance of HP in this sector. They hold the second position in most shipping PC equipment. They had a market share of 20% and 40.5% is the printer share. They have differentiated products. So for example, HP has produced well-advanced differentiated products such as HP Spectre. It is a fantastic piece of equipment for laptop. And they also have a Chromebook, and the Chromebook is the top 10 most high specifications Chromebooks in the world. Next is the weaknesses of HP. The weaknesses of HP is the high dependency on the current product. As I mentioned, although their sales is high in terms of printer and computers, but the sales in that industry itself is declining over time. So they need to venture into new kinds of products to make sure that sales will increase. Next is less presence in the developed market. Although we rank at the top 10 for the Chromebook, for dealers, its existence still not noticeable and have less market demands according to their annual report 2017. HP presence in this area weaker compared to competitors such as Samsung and also Lenovo. The opportunities for the operations of HP is that they could venture into 3D printers market. The 3D printers market is right now is expected to have high growth. They will reach a value of 30.2 billion by 2022 with a CAGR of 28.5%. Then they could venture into medical sector. Right now the company is using most medical sector is using SaaS, which is they only buy software and use their computer, but HP can use their desktop to provide software and sell the desktop with the software inside it to the hospitals. Next, the threats and make sure they are up to the advancement of technology and meet the customer expectation. But HP is currently just following their norm phase of getting into new products and technology advancement. Next, the strategies to boost product sales. As I mentioned, for the opportunities is now the potential in 3D printers. These 3D printers is enable manufacturers to develop product using a digital file and a variety of printing materials. This market is into polymers. These printing materials include polymers, metals, and ceramics. And the industries who are using this is automotive, aerospace, and also apparel. As I've mentioned just now, there will be 30.2 billion profit by 2022 for the 3D market. And the worldwide shipment of 3D printers has grew by 103% in 2016 by the Market and Markets Research. For HP itself, in 2016, they have increased by 2% to invest on 3D printers. Therefore, my suggestion for the strategy is for them to increase by another 8%, which is a greater of 10%, to make sure they can get more sales as this market is growing so fast. So for my needs is that I need the finance to make sure that they can increase the amount by 10% within 1 year, and then the marketing to go into markets and see which department they can venture into, such as I mentioned before, aerospace and also apparel. The apparel, for example, you might be wondering, but Nike in 2014 has reported that 30% of their growth is by the 3D printing technology, because by they buying the 3D printing technology, they have boosted their sales by 15%. And in that it was in 2014. So in like other apparel companies, they can boost their market to what such as Nike has been doing. So HP can venture into other apparel market. Next is the medical sector. So this software-enabled service model is better compared to SaaS. As you can see the chart right here, it shows that the medical technology sales is increasing gradually 5.2% per year. And its sales is nearly reaching 530 billion for right now. For your information, more than half of US hospitals use some type of electronic record system, but only 6% meet all the federal mandates. And 50% of healthcare dollars are wasted on inefficient record keeping process. For example, right now, if you go to any general hospital, they are using the old method of keeping tracks of their patients. For example, their personal information, health details and everything. So by using this service-enabled model, they will save more time and gain more money. So I will proceed.
A very good afternoon to me, Sarah, and my fellow friends. My name is Sanjay Patterson, and I'm representing the marketing department of HP. So we have heard so many good things about HP. So what is the problem statement? I'm not going to say anything new, as what my friend has mentioned, a decline in sales by 6.3% from year 2015 to 2016, especially in the sales of PCs and printers. So having a problem statement, the marketing department has came up with three main objectives. Number one is to increase the retention rate of customers by 14% by the end of 2018. Number two is to promote our new technologies, new services, 3D printing, everything like what my friend mentioned just now about venturing to airline and all that by 2018, and also to lead the marketplace. And the third one is to venture into new market sectors by delivering new products, services, and solutions by 2018. So for situation analysis of HP, we need two SWOT and TWAS analysis, but for the time being, I'm only going to explain about SWOT. So number one, HP has a fantastic brand equity and a brand valuation booking at $19.3 billion, making it as the 50th position in the top 100 brands in the global around the world. And also, it's ranked at the 10th place in the IT industry. So why am I saying this? I'm from the marketing department. Why? This is because these are all points for the marketing department when we are doing our sales promotion, when our salesperson are going up to promote our product. We have all this proof to show the customers that yes, we are the top brand in the world. Third is that HP is known as smart marketer. Smart marketer meaning during the campaigns and advertisement, they actually use very catchy and colorful advertisements, and they also use celebrities in their advertisements. Witness is that during when we discussed my financial analyst, he told me that you know the marketing department has to slash by 50% for the money spent in advertisement. So this is a bad news for the marketing department, definitely. Second is poor after sales service. So the moment my friend said, business analyst said, you type, it comes up. The review is so bad about HP. So my customers, when I go and talk to them, promote my product, the first thing they say is that, no, your after service is so bad. So it is a weakness for the marketing department as well. And number three is lack of well-trained sales promoters. I have discussed with my HR department, and we actually came up with this solution that yes, they actually have lack of sales promoters who are well-trained. When it comes to opportunity, my friend just mentioned about 3D printing, and yes, the marketing department is taking it very seriously to promote the 3D printing into all the marketplaces that the operation manager just mentioned, and also to enter the new marketplaces such as hospitals and hotels. For trends, nothing new, too many competition from Dell, Toshiba, Acer. Even though this year Dell, the sales of HP actually overtook Dell, but still the competitors are still there. So the implementation strategy we use through STP process and the marketing mix. STP, we use the demographic segmentation for the segmenting part. So the age we chose was 21 years old and above. So generation Y, we chose generation Y. Why? Because generation X in Malaysia consists of 55%. Generation Y, 44%. But we still chose generation Y because they are more out of the box, they think of innovation, they want special features, they are less price sensitive. But where generation I are more about the quality, are more about the price, they compare the price more. So we prefer generation Y. And income starts at 1,500 because we have students as our target market, and it can go up to 15,000 and more because our target market are also hospitals. So these are our target market, business industry, students and healthcare industry. I will not go deep in it. And for the positioning part, HP, you know, is one of the big gamer in the IT industry. But how it's still moving on, you know, making efforts to maintain the brand value. It is actually working with moving brands to redesign their products. Innovation can be a lofty goal for many companies. They don't care about innovation. But for HP, innovation is their top strategic plan, and they have come out with great brand loyalty. So for marketing needs, number one product. We have laptops, various laptops, any laptop, compact laptops, table, desktop, we have the pavilion desktop, we have the pavilion, home, any desktop, laser printers, inkjet printers, and multifunctional printers. As for price, we use two, which is fixed and dynamic pricing strategy. Into fixed, we have promotional and bundling. Promotional means we give discounts to our customers. Not only discounts, we also give bundling products, means free gift. Such as you buy a laptop, I'll give you 30% off for your Microsoft Office, I will give you free 3GB hard drive. So these are the strategy which is used by HP. When it comes to segmenting, segmenting means you pay for what you use. So this is a special offer that is being given by HP according to a source called Business Wire. So how it's called is that you know CPU, right? Computing processing unit. So you actually use that to actually calculate the percentage of processors used. So for promotion, we have personal selling. And for personal selling, I have actually discussed with my HR manager that we need well-trained personal sellers, which is for following the formula of ADAS. ADAS means attention, interest, desire, action, and satisfaction. I cannot go deep into it. My tongue is buzzing me, but you all can always go and Google what that ADAS means. And I need 5,000 to 8,000 ringgit for the foundation department for transportation and rental. Promotion, nothing new. Social media is one of our main goals. You can see we have Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. So that is what we are mainly using for promoting my HP. And also, we have billboards, newspapers, and we also want to sponsor football game. But my financial analyst told me not to do it yet because the budget is low. So we are holding that back. Thank you. I have place to go for one more. So very fast, place is that we actually have stores and we also have online websites. So you all can buy from the online portal or you can go to any store and buy purchase HP. Thank you.
Okay, so hello everyone. Today I'll be representing the HP Finance Department. So as mentioned earlier, the HP's total revenue have decreased by 6.3% from year 2015 to 2016. The net revenue generated from the United States have increased by 1.7% to 18 billion, but the net revenue from outside the United States have decreased by 10.4% to only 13.2 billion. So the finance department have come out with these three objectives. The first one is to increase the total revenue of HP by 15% by the end of the year 2017, and to increase the return on investment by 5% and providing higher dividends to shareholders before the end of the year 2017. The last one is that we're going to improve the cost efficiency of HP by 5% and reduce the debt level by 6% at the end of the year 2017. So I'll be doing the financial analysis. The first standard that we're going to analyze is to use the liquidity ratio. Liquidity ratio is a method for companies to measure a company's ability to pay off their short-term debts. And it consists of current ratio and equity ratio. The table above says that the current ratio of HP improved from 2011 to 2015, but dropped significantly from 2015 to 2016 by 13.33%, from 1.23 to only 0.98. Quick ratio improved from 2016 to 2015, but dropped significantly from 2015 to 2016 by 31.25%. Therefore, we can know that HP Incorporation is starting to get weaker when it comes to the ability to pay off their current liabilities such as creditors, group expenses, interest payable, etc. The next method we're going to use is the profitability ratio. It is a ratio that measures a company's performance by measuring their profitability. Common ratios used are gross profit margin, net profit margin, operating margin, return on assets, return on equity, and lastly, return on investments. Based on the table above, we have the following information. The gross profit margin of HP has been reducing for over 5 years. Net profit margin reduced from year 2013 to 2015, but improved in 2016. Operating profit margin increased from year 2014 to 2015, but dropped slightly in 2016. Return on assets increased from 2013 to 2014, but started decreasing afterwards. Return on equity reduced from 2013 to 2015, but improved in 2016. Return on investments increased from 2013 to 2015, but started decreasing upwards from 2015 to 2016. Next one, we are going to do the SWOT analysis. HP's strength is that they have international presence and they are brand providers. The next one is that they have a wide range of products and services and a good distribution network. HP's weakness is that they are relying too much on PC and computer sales, and they have poor presence in smartphones and tablets, and they are actually financially weak when compared to other rivals. HP's opportunities is that they can have more, they can invest more on cloud business, and they can expand distribution of smartphones and tablets, and they can also have more product diversification. HP's strength is that they are having declining PC and laptop sales and intensifying competition. The next one is that we're going to give strategies and recommendations from the finance department. The first one we're going to do is that we're going to recommend HP to And those assets can be like machines, equipment, vehicles, used buildings, etc. So that they can sell the assets and get the money to pay off their creditors. And we estimate that HP will be able to reduce their debt level by 3% through dividends and used assets. The next one we're going to recommend for HP is that HP should search for suppliers that can they are willing to provide lower price but having the final quality so that HP can reduce their cost of production, hence higher profitability. The financing power recommends HP to search for suppliers to China so that because China suppliers they are willing to provide raw materials at lower cost. We also encourage HP to search for suppliers in China who are able to provide more longer credit terms so that HP can have more time to pay back their suppliers. The financial department will require that focus from the HR department, and we are estimating a budget for $900 per broker and $3,550 as food and accommodation expenses for each broker. We are estimating that this would effectively improve HP's cost efficiency and revenue by 5% if we are able to successfully buy the super raw material supplies. The last one we are going to recommend with HP is that HP can provide more attractive installment plans so that customers can have more, they don't need to pay their purchases in full amount so that they can. We believe that the sales of HP will actually increase by 10% if more attractive installment plans are provided to customers. The finance department will communicate and collaborate with the well-known banks from all over the world and discuss about the best installment plans for customers so that customers all around the world can pay for their purchases from installments without paying for a full amount. So this is the estimated budget for the implementation strategy for all departments. We're estimating that the total budget will be $820,959,500. Next, I'll pass to
Good afternoon, Sarah and my fellow friends. So I'm Julio, I'm judge of the HP Human Resource Department. So my first statement is HP recently we have cut off their major shake-up in their recently, which is they cut off their enterprise team and two marketing officers from their position, then they move their BCG to another division. This they need to start in a different department and their painting division team stepped down after 22 years stop. And one of the other problem is that this team they need to lay off 29,000 workers in the year 2014. So this is quite a big problem for the human resource department to find them to replace the existing positions and to lay off workers. Our objective is to allow the employees to have better rewards and benefits. This is their employment fees. Therefore, training and development for the employees itself, and of course for recruiting processes to recruit new workers to this team. The SWOT is basically the same. Yeah, not much time, so I skip this part. They know my strategies and recommendations is training and development for employees. Like what Sanjeev from marketing department said that they need train workers for their marketing. So that part is data center for them. Then recovery mentioned for overall that each employee need to be trained in their specific field so that they can perform better in their work, daily work. And one more is of course from the financial department that for this thing need around quite a number, the high number of money to conduct training development for employees. Then second is the recruiting from universities. So the 10 million that from Shenzhen we use for the recruiting from universities because most of the recruiting processes nowadays are made through online, but 30% of our employees are basically recruited from the universities after the graduate is recruited. So in order to do that, we need money of course. So it's much easier process because after the graduate, of course, they want to ensure that it's straight from the universities to that. And others know it's online, so basically we need money for recruiting talent from the universities. And of course, recruit professional workers for yourself. Then third is covered better for benefit of cost, medical and health care, income protection insurance, and of course their workers after they work at this PA form, they work long enough, they can have 5% discount to buy this insurance. So this is one of the benefits of HR that we have given out to the citizen. And retirement and saving plans for workers for their future. Other than that, I think that